Homeopathic pharmacy. Starting with the definition, so homeopathic pharmacy is an art and science by means of which we can acquire a sound knowledge about the art of identifying and collecting medicinal substances from different sources of nature, preparing, preserving them in laboratory, combining and compounding them according to rules and regulation of homeopathic pharmacopoeia, and dispensing them according to physician's prescription. According to HPI, that is Homeopathic Pharmacopoeia of India, homeopathic pharmacy is concerned with the collection, identification, preparation, standardization, and preservation of the drug used in homeopathic practice. Basics of homeopathic pharmacy is mainly based on three things: monopharmacy, pharmacodynamics, and potentization. It is known as science, a department of systemized knowledge as an object of study, knowledge of covering general truth or the operation of general laws, especially as obtained and tested through scientific methods. It is known as art because systemic application of knowledge of skill in effecting a desired result. Pharmacy is a study of cardinal principles of a subject. The scientific process is adopted and the nature, the principle is applied successfully for the attainment of higher purposes of healing art. Therefore, pharmacy is known as science as well as art. Sources of homeopathic pharmacy. The main sources are Hahnemann's writing. First, 1810 to 1921, that is Organon of Medicine, 1st to 6th edition. 1811 to 1821, that is Materia Medica Pura, that is volume 1 to 6. 1820, on the preparation and dispensing of medicine, homeopathic physician. 1828 to 1830, that is Chronic Disease, volume 1 to volume 4. Then lesser writings of Hahnemann, which mainly includes, first, Essay on New Principle for Ascertaining the Curative Power of Drug and some examination of the previous principles, which is published in Hufflin's Journal. 1808, on the value of speculative system of medicine, especially in connection with various system of practice. Third, on the preparation and dispensing of the medicines of homeopathic physician. Homeopathic pharmacy includes, first, collection, that is gathering or procuring the required drug substance. Second is identification, that is ascertaining the genuineness and purity of the drug substance. It is done by macroscopical, microscopical and chemical studies. Third, qualitative analysis, that is the process of ascertaining the presence or absence of certain substance in a sample, what impurities are present, or confirming the absence of certain impurities. Fourth, quantitative analysis, that is having ascertained the nature of constituent of a given sample, the process of determining how much of each component or specified component is present in quantitative analysis. Fifth is preserving. Drug substances have to be kept from destruction of their medicinal substances, medicinal power. Then sixth, that is standardizing, that is medicine prepared should conform to the official homeopathic pharmacopoeia or any other authoritative text so as to maintain a uniformity in the preparation of the medicine. Seventh is combining. It is the act of uniting two or more substances physically or chemically. If it is physically, then they are known as mixtures. If they are chemically, then they are known as compounds. Then eighth is compounding. Act of uniting two or more elements in a fixed proportion to an altogether new product. This new product will have properties different from those of constituent. Like for example, calcarea sulf, magnesium mure, natrum arsenic, etc. are all compounds. And last, that is dispensing. It means preparing and serving the medicinal preparation as per the direction of the physician. Branches of homeopathic pharmacy. First is pharmacy proper. Second is gerential pharmacy. Scopes of homeopathic pharmacy during study and practice of homeopathy. That is, first, studying homeopathic pharmacy provide us with the knowledge of preparing mother tincture and its dilution. Knowledge of homeopathic pharmacy helps us in selecting the right dosage to be prescribed to the patient. That is the knowledge of posology. Then, it helps in writing prescription in the proper form. And last, knowledge of external application of a particular drug.